Hi friends, welcome to Exams Daily YouTube channel. Today in this video, I would like to share you about the latest and important current affairs of 3rd December 2020. Before that, don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and click the bell icon for daily updates. National Affairs. Union Petroleum Minister Dharmendra Pradhan launches country's first 100-octane petrol XP100. Union Minister for Petroleum and Natural Gas and Steel Dr. Dharmendra Pradhan has launched the country's first 100-octane premium petrol virtually through video conferencing. Branded as XP100, the premium-grade petrol was launched across 10 cities. The second phase will see the addition of 5 more cities like Kolkata and Chennai. This XP100 developed by Indian Oil Corporation Limited. So, about Union Petrol Ministry is, the Union Minister of Union Petrol Ministry is Dharmendra Pradhan. State Affairs. Karnataka launches learning management system for students and teachers. The Chief Minister of Karnataka, B.S. Yediyurappa, has launched the learning management system for students and teachers of the state. The system is implemented at an estimated cost of ₹34.14 crore. Through this system, nearly 4.5 lakh students and 24,000 teachers will be benefited. This also encourages digital learning, would improve the quality and gross enrollment ratio in higher education. And more about Karnataka is, the capital of Karnataka is Bangalore and the present governor is Vajubhai Wala and the present chief minister of Karnataka is B.S. Yediyurappa. Uttarakhand state government initiates 5-star village postal scheme. The communication minister for state, who is Sanjay Dhotre, has initiated the 5-star village postal scheme. The scheme ensures the universal coverage of flagship postal schemes. The main is to ensure universal coverage of flagship postal schemes in rural areas of the country. Now, all postal products and services will be made available and marketed and publicized at village level under the 5-star village schemes. And more about Uttarakhand is, the present governor is Baby Rani Maurya and the present chief minister of Uttarakhand is Trivendra Singh Rawat. Shipping Ministry to launch Ramayan cruise service on River Sarayu, River of Ayodhya. The Ramayan cruise tour will be launched on the Sarayu River in Ayodhya. This was officially announced by the Minister of Ports, Shipping and Waterways, Manshukh Mandaria. The cruise service will be launched on the Gahra National Waterways 40. The main aim for launching this cruise service is to provide unique experience to the devotees. And more about Uttar Pradesh is, the capital of Uttar Pradesh is Lucknow and the present governor is Anandiben Patel and the chief minister of this state is Yogi Adityanath. India's first organ donor memorial inaugurated by Rajasthan CM in Jaipur. Rajasthan Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot inaugurated the country's first organ donor memorial in Jaipur. This memorial has been established jointly by Mohan Foundation Jaipur Citizen Forum and the Jaipur Municipal Corporation. This memorial has been built to acknowledge the organ donor sacrifice. The memorial is inspired by the famous Jantar Mantar of Jaipur. And more about Rajasthan is, the capital of Rajasthan is Jaipur and the present governor is Kalraj Mishra and the present chief minister of this state is Ashok Gehlot. Rankings and reports. World Malaria Report 2020 released by WHO. WHO, which was also known as World Health Organization, it is a specialized agency of the United Nations which are responsible for international public health, has released the World Malaria Report 2020. According to this report, India has recorded the largest reduction in malaria cases in Southeast Asian countries. India has reduced the malarian cases by 21% between 2018 and 2019. The top 5 highest malaria burden countries are Cameroon, Democratic Republic of Congo, Burkina Faso, Mozambique, and Mali. And more about WHO is, the headquarters of WHO is located in Switzerland and it was founded on 7th April 1948. WTO publishes World Trade Report 2020. WTO, which was also known as World Trade Organization, it is an international organization for the regulation of international trade. They have released the World Trade Report 2020. As per this report, the Asian powerhouses, which has India, China and Japan, has contributed to 40% of world research and development in 2017. The contribution was 8.2% in 1996. The report mainly focused on technology and innovation policies in the current digitalizing world economy. And more about VTO is, the headquarters is located in Switzerland and it was founded on 1st January 1995. Banking Affairs. SBI collaborates with NPCI and JCP Japan to unveil SBI Rupee JCP Platinum contactless debit card. The State Bank of India has collaborated with Japan's JCP and National Payments Corporation of India, which is also known as NPCI. It is an umbrella organization for operating retail payments and settlement systems. The main aim of this collaboration is to launch new debit card, which was known as the SBI Rupee JCP Platinum Contactless Debit Card. This card enables the customers to use it for both contact and contactless transaction. Customers can use this card as ATMs or else as POS terminals across the globe under JCP network. And more about SBI is, the chairperson of SBI is Dinesh Kumar Gehra and the headquarters is located in Mumbai and it was founded on 1st July 1955. Appointment. Senior IAS officer Varsha Joshi designated as interim chairperson of NDDB succeed Dilip Rath. Indian government has appointed Varsha Joshi as the interim chairperson of NDDB. The NDDB is which was known as the National Dairy Development Board. Joshi succeeded Dilip Rath in the contest and Joshi was served as the joint secretary of CDD, the Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying, which was running under the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying. And more about NDDB is, it was founded on 16th July 1965 and the present chairman who was selected is Varsha Joshi. Economy. OECD forecast India's GDP at -9.9% for fiscal year 2021. The OECD, which was known as the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, it is an intergovernmental economic organization. They have forecasted India's GDP for the year 2021 and they have forecasted as -9.9%. This organization has also projected the world GDP to contract 4.2% in 2020. This estimate was -4.5% in September forecast. Meanwhile, global GDP is projected as 3.7% for the year 2022. So about OECD is, its headquarters is located in France and it was founded on 13th September 1961 and the present Secretary General of this organization is Jose Angel Gurria. Defense News. DRDO launches new laboratory named Defense Geoinformatics Research Establishment. The DRDO, which was known as the Defense Research Development Organization, they have launched a new laboratory named Defense Geoinformatics Research Establishment. The new lab was set up by merging the existing labs, that is the Manali-based SHOW and Avalanche Studies Establishment and the Delhi-based Defense Terrain Research Establishment. And more about DRDO is, it was founded on 1958. The headquarters is located in New Delhi and the present chairman is Dr. G. Satish Reddy. Important days. International Day of Persons with Disabilities is observed on December 3. Every year, International Day of Persons with Disabilities is observed on December 3. The main objective of this day is to promote the rights and well-being of persons with disabilities in all spheres of society and development. The United Nations has been observing this day since 1992 after passing United Nations General Assembly resolution. So, these are the very latest and important current affairs of today. So, if you like this video and if you think this video is very useful for you, don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and click the bell icon for daily updates. Thank you.